Het wordt steeds populairder om naar Turkije te reizen voor verschillende esthetische operaties. Hierbij kan je denken aan plastische chirurgie, haartransplantatie en zelfs IVF-behandelingen. Vandaag zijn we bij MCAN Health om hier meer over te weten te komen.
Recently, we observe a high increase in cosmetic surgery and plastic surgery demand. It's because of social media, of course. Then we had COVID, we locked down and we started to work remotely. I think seeing ourselves more than ever because of COVID caused a rise in plastic surgery. It has also a name, Zoom effect in plastic surgery. People are coming from abroad for plastic surgeries, weight loss surgeries, cosmetic dentistry, and hair transplantation. The reason, because these are elective surgeries, they are not covered by the social security institutions. That's why people search for the quality treatment with a reasonable price. In plastic surgeries, mostly we perform rhinoplasty, breast surgeries, and all body lifting surgeries. In weight loss surgeries, gastric sleeve is the most popular one. And in dentistry, I can say that implants, veneers, crowns. The consultations for the patients from overseas goes with the pictures and by receiving some basic medical information. Then we allow the doctors to put the right indication for that specific patients. Of course, there are video calls between the doctor and the patient to just answer the questions of the patient, to understand the expectation, and then to advise the patient the right treatment plans. Patients from Europe generally comes alone, so you need to take care of them from A to Z. The drivers should meet them at the airport. The hotel organization should be already performed. And each patient is assigned one patient host and one nurse. Patient host speaks in their own mother language and accompany them during the entire journey. And then the nurses visit after the discharge in their hotel to make dressing change, to help them to wash, to check on the vital signs. Each and every patient receives aftercare instructions. Once the patient arrives to the home country, regular emails are sent based on the treatment with certain intervals. Apart from that, the first 15 days is very important after the surgery. So the nurses should follow them by phone calling how the healing process is going on.
Een van hun meest voorkomende behandelingen is een haartransplantatie. Hoe zo'n behandeling in zijn werk gaat, dat gaan we nu zien.
For hair transplantation, there is specific two methods worldwide known. First one is follicular unit extraction and second one is direct hair implantation. They depend on the patient's situation, medical background and wishes as well. So medical professionals can prefer each way with consultation with the patient. The first step is taking patient's medical history and background, which is very crucial. And during that time, we outline the hair loss areas and patient's wishes, of course. After that, medical professionals draw some blood tests if the patient is ready for the operation or not. And then shaving the hair, the procedure starts, which takes around 6 to 8 hours. And medical professionals can provide some medications as well. Patients go back to their routine after 3 days. First 15 days are so important due to wound healing process. The whole process, if the patients want to see the exact result, will take around 12 to 18 months. So patients should be patient during this period.